Hello, Mr. Newton here. So I'm going to go through the mods that I have installed for the game Torchlight 1, released in 2009. So back in October 2020, I started a Torchlight campaign playing as the Vanquisher class, played the vanilla game. I played for 2 episodes. I played the first act and the second act. After that, I found a site where I could get a lot of mods by installing the mod drop like launcher that will easily install smaller mods and bigger mods, and then you can choose which ones to install. Of course, not all of them are compatible, and I believe I spent a lot of time to making them all compatible. At first I aimed at continuing the campaign as the Vanquisher but with some mods, and it worked fine. But all of a sudden the campaign or the save became corrupted and I couldn't load it anymore. Also, there were a cool downloadable feature where you could play multiplayer over LAN in Torchlight 1 if you installed a mod for it. It's not available as a sub-mod, you need to get it from a specific site, and it only worked for Steam. I had originally bought two versions of Torchlight 1 in the store around 2009 and 2010, I believe, because I thought I could play LAN with friends, but it wasn't possible. It only had single player. So I had 2 versions of the CD. I ended up giving one of the copies to my sister because she likes Diablo 2, and then I thought this game would also be liked by her. So she got one of the CD versions that I had, and the other one I had installed on this computer, and I played it last time I recorded this game. But because I found that mod enabling LAN, it added a new, I believe, UI where it added multiplayer LAN, and it only worked on the Steam version of Torchlight. So I bought it again on Steam, and then I installed that feature. So now I am playing using the Steam version, and multiplayer works, but it's kind of buggy because even if the game works fine, I believe there were an issue preventing the player from using the hot seat buttons or something. I believe certain UI buttons didn't work as intended when using the multiplayer function. That's why I probably deactivated the mod. But it's possible to play the Torchlight 1 campaign with a friend now. But unfortunately the quick buttons do not work when playing multiplayer, so one will have to do everything the slow way, the manual way. Okay, and you need the Steam version for the multiplayer mode to function. But now we're going to go through the other modes. As I said, the save with my Vanquisher, I had played the first 2 acts and recorded, it got corrupted, so I had to start all over. So I believe I spent same amount of time, probably 4 hours or something, playing everything again. But this time I played with a lot of cool mods, including a mod that changed the look of the character and other stuff. We will check them now. So we have the pets mod here. Let's check it. So with sound preview, pet, no whimper, dog, no whimper. We have in this game you can have 2 pets at the start. A dog and a cat, I believe, and this mod makes the dog no whimper. Okay, so changes the sounds your pet dog makes when its health gets too low, from whimpering to growling. Great if you don't want your dog to ever sound like a wimp. Okay, so it changes the sound of the dog to look to sound more tough, and it no longer sounds like a wimp. Okay, so that's a minor mod that I thought was good. And then we have the merchant, Terra General Merchant. Let's check it. A simple mod I made that turned the General Merchant from Turn into Terra the General Merchant. So a merchant that looks like this instead of the old look. It only changes the look of the merchant. I like this look better. I believe she had pink hair or something previously. Okay, and then so all of these mods are unused. Then we have the Visea Pet Shop. This mod will make general shop sell permanent fish, transform your pet. Okay, sell permanent fish, transform your pet into new monster. Okay, so in this game you could sometimes fish, you can fish at certain locations, and when you fish you can sometimes get fishes, and these fishes, they can sometimes transform your character to monsters for a limited period of time. So this mod will make the general shop sell permanent fish transform. So they will transform you into monsters, so you will look like a monster, but they are permanent, so you will not return to your old look. You will look like a monster all the time. So it's like a feature where you can buy fishes, changing your model to a monster, and then you can play as that monster for the rest of the game. I'm not gonna use this feature when playing and recording, because I want the Vanquisher to be the Vanquisher during my let's play of the Vanquisher. But it's a cool feature that I've tried out, and I thought it was cool, so I installed it. So we can be both some ordinary monsters and some boss monsters. It also includes the respec mod, so we could probably, I believe, specs are like abilities, so you can probably, if you have already given your character a lot of abilities, then you can probably erase that and start all over, and handing out the abilities again if you want to do it differently. Okay. Then we have the troll retextures, retexes, and we can see here that the green troll will look like this, the red like this, and then we have the rock troll and the gray troll. So pretty much a texture pack for the trolls, making them look better. This mod retexes the trolls for more variety. I believe the old troll only had one color, and now we have four different ones. I thought just having different colors was a little disappointing, so they all have unique features and they won't be so boring. So they not only have different colors like before, they have that according to the text. Instead they have some new features too. Okay, I installed that as well, I thought it was cool. And then we have the Tanky Pets version 1.1. Tanky Pets mod version 1.1. A mod I created to make the standard cat and dog pets a little more durable for hard play. Yeah, because the pets were just as bad in later areas of the game as they were in the beginning. They didn't improve, so they were worthless in the late game. So I found them to be much too wimpy versus equal or near equal level monsters. I see. So if you faced a monster on the same level or near the same level as the pet, they were always weaker. But now, thanks to this mod, the pets, the cat and the dogs, they won't be weaker. They will be able to fight monsters around the same level as them. Okay, usually within seconds of an encounter they were hurt and fleeing. This mod increases your pet's health and resistances by 25%. And its armor by 20%, and also reduces the physical damage it inflicts. In line with the tanking class, okay, the pet spells and the transformations are not affected in any way. By no means will your pet be invulnerable and will still suffer enough damage to flee if swamped by mobs or attacked by a powerful boss. But this should happen less often than before. Okay, and then there are some changes to the stats. This mod is incompatible with any mod which makes alterations to your dog or cat dat files. Okay, so that's a mod that improves the pets. I thought it was a good update, and the starting gold increase, it's kinda self-explanatory what it does. Hello all, thought I would upload another I'm bored mods. This contains three mods in one rare file. Starting gold when making a new character, so we get 10,000, 50,000 or 10,000 depending on which one we choose. I don't remember which one I did pick, but we have more money at the start, so we can buy some good stuff from the vendors immediately. I've already started the game with all these mods active and played the first and second levels, the ones I had already recorded. So we'll start on the third level. Okay, I have completely different gear because I got other items to drop and such. excuse me. I actually think that I did a better job playing the game the second try. I were more aggressive and I used better tactics, better attacks and such, so it went better. I killed the boss more easily. I have better gear, I believe, too. I did some bonus levels as well with lava that weren't in the original game because they're part of a submod, probably. So in a sense it was sad that I didn't record, but I thought it would be faster to play those two levels again, the two acts, if I didn't record, because then I don't have to speak. Can just play as fast as possible. Okay, then we have the gameplay, starting with, we already checked that. Then we have the smarter pets and minions, we'll check that. This mod does two things. One, makes all pets, minions and summon spells behave more intelligently. All pets will now spot and react to enemies within the default screen, but should not pursue them beyond the screen's edge. They will also come to your aid much more often. The default distance to react to you taking damage was rather short in most cases. 2. Skeleton warriors, blood skeletons, skeleton archers and zombies, which are the summoned monsters, now have unlimited duration. Yeah, they used to disappear after a short while. Now they will stay forever until they are killed. They can die resummoning them when an arbitrary counter win stun doesn't add anything into the game, in my opinion. After implementing this change, found out that pets can sometimes resummon charm spells when the cooldown runs out without desummoning the originals, creating armies of skeletons. While funny, this was obviously unbalanced, so I fixed it. I see. Found out that pets can sometimes resummon charm spells when the cooldown runs out without desummoning the originals. I see. I would have liked that. I used to play Diablo 2 with the Necromancer and have armies of monsters. So I would have liked that, but he has fixed it, okay. If you don't like the summon spell duration changes, simply delete the fixes and skills folders and keep the units folder in place. This mod only addresses the default pets, including pet variations based on fish ring, minions and summon spells. If you have any mods that add pets, this will not affect them. And if you have any mods that alter the original pet skills, this will likely conflict with them, okay. Then we have the small floated text mod. So mod description, we can check here. So the text when fighting is smaller, which I thought was good. I don't like when the text takes up too much of the window. This mod reduces the size of the in-game floated text that pops up when taking damage, hitting creatures, blocking, glancing, blow, and hit points, mana, stealing. Blocking, glancing, blow, okay. I found the default floated text to be a nightmare with my up close and personal warrior build. You can't see the action too well behind the default text. I made this mod. Yeah, that's good. I like it. And then the respec mod allows you to purchase respec potions from the general inventory vendor. Read me. This respec mod causes the general inventory vendor hit points, MP, potions, identify town portal scrolls to offer the respect potion. So when you take that potion, you will be able to give your character all his or her skills again from scratch. So it's a potion that does that. Then we have the potion stack size. Make your health points, mana points, potions, and identify town portal scrolls. Max stack size to 200. So it increases the max stack size to 200 from something else. Okay, that's good, I think. And then we have the more stash mod. More stash adds 19 stash chests to the game, giving you a grand total of 20 stash chests. So we have many stash chests in the cities or towns, or the main town probably, and where we can place stuff that we get in the game, so we won't run out of space very soon. I believe we have a lot of space to store stuff now. Okay, and then we have the merchant pack. This mod adds map, fish, gem, spell and scroll, potion and ranged weapon sellers to the town. It also modifies the blacksmith, general merchant and gem trinket seller to remove overlapping inventories. Okay, so we have more shops now and more items to buy, etc. And then we have the media loot fix. It makes media capable of dropping her unique set. She drops exactly one of the three at a time. So you need to kill her three times to get all of her stuff, but media is a boss probably, and you get her stuff. Okay, and then we have the inventory mod. This mod makes more space of your inventory available. It moves town portal and identity scrolls to spells tab. Same applies to potions, except fish potions, which are moved to fishes tab. It has also risen max stack value to 200. Important, before applying this mod to existing characters, move all the items in their possessions that this mod changes, scrolls and potions, to the stash, or you'll lose them. Okay. And then we have the I hate fishing mod. Fishing could be annoying or frustrating because it fails too often. Okay, I really do hate fishing. In this game I find it really tedious, although you can find some cool stuff fishing. This mod makes the monster do the fishing so you don't have to. I don't know if this actually worked. I tried to fish with this one but it didn't really work, I believe. It's supposed to make the summoned monster or your pet fish for you, I believe. Okay, so you don't have to do it. Then there is the healthy pet mod, somewhat healthy. Here's an excellent mod that somehow never made it onto the site, though it is still available at Mediafire. Figure it'll be more appreciated here, so I'm uploading it. All credit goes to Average Oddity, of course. All I did was rename the folder and add a mod.dat file. Original release thread coded below. Okay, so this will increase the health of the pets. It's another mod that makes the pets better, the cats and the dogs. Then we have the giant trollfish. Okay, we can check the picture. So now I believe we can have this as a pet, this guy and troll, at the start of the game. GTF, guy and troll fix adds the impossibly large fish which permanently turns your pet into a troll. The impossibly large fish has a rarity of 1000, as common glopper, yell, etc., and can be caught on any level. I also made the troll speed to be the same as a cat because the normal troll is painfully slow. This mod does not affect any existing items or monsters. Okay. So if we want our pet to be a giant troll, we can use this. I won't use it during the let's play too. Then we have the frost shield glow remover. This little mod removes something that annoyed many people, including me. Huge bright glowing sphere of the destroyer's frost shield scale. It might be more difficult to track when it's up and when it ran out, so keep track of the timer. Or download my other mod to make it easier. Okay, it removes something, a glow game and doing a certain skill probably. Epic boss maps. This was the one that made the game in certain places spawn me into other areas where you had to fight hard monsters, and you could also get not only did you get experience by killing those boss monsters, but you also get some gear there. Good gear. So epic boss maps. I made a mod with which basically makes a map filled with boss monsters. You need to be level 20 or higher to play them. You can buy them from the merchant that sells maps in town. They are named epic boss maps. There's a boss map for each type of tile set in the game. To install the mod, it might not have been this mod, but I believe I have some mod that that added extra areas. Okay, then we have the enhanced GUI. So this mod retextures the GUI to make more visually interesting and less flat. Okay, so the GUI, it's the game user interface. Goes really nice with my enhanced textures, as both mods do similar things to different parts of the game textures. So this is the new user interface that I'm using. Much better and nicer, cleaner than the old one. So he's using a mod, probably turning him into this monster. Okay, so we have that in the game too, and then we had the enemy weapon variety mod. Tired of seeing the same weapons in the hands of the hordes of disciples, skeletons, lizard men, waits, and goblins. This mod allows all sorts of different weapons to spawn in the hands of your enemies to shake things up a bit. To be more specific, all melee forms of the above can now spawn with swords, maces, axes, and or polearms. Archers use a variety of bows, and goblin mages, slash reloads can use staves or wands. So monsters have a variety in weapons, which I thought was good. Previously all monsters of a certain type had the same weapon. Okay, pets, dog and cat, dash. Simple mod which adds the Goblin Hunt's dash ability to your base pets and increases their combat effectiveness somewhat. It makes pets better, which I thought was good as well. Then we have better balanced sale prices. This mod offers exactly what the title says, better balanced sale prices. Vendors now offer more gold in exchange for your items, so selling rare and unique equipment no longer leaves you feeling like you've been kicked in the teeth. However, please note that this mod is intended to be balanced. You will not be able to reap plentiful gold from every item you come across. Normal items have received a marginal increase in sale price. Magical items have received a moderate increase in sale price, and unique items have received a substantial increase in sale price. Additionally, the amount of gold received scales with the item level. Without modding and with no barter skill, the percentage of gold received for selling an item in relation to its purchase price is as follows. And then we can see there some details. Although no value seems small, bear in mind that drops are quite abundant, and even though your items' new sale prices are still only a fraction of their purchase price, the new percentages will often make your sale prices two or three times higher than the unmodified prices when selling magic or and unique items. This makes a big yet balanced difference late in the game. This mod has been tuned and tested to ensure it is not exploitable with the barter skill. Even with max barter, you will never be able to sell an item to a vendor for a price higher than its purchase price. There are a handful of items that can be sold to a vendor for a price equal to its purchase price with max barter. But these are all low-level items, in essence minor health potions and level 1 equipment that can only be bought as or sold for 20 gold with max barter. The mod folder has a, we don't need to know that, but this changes the prices to be better balanced. You get more for your stuff, but you still won't get the full price of an item. Okay, because all items you use are used, of course. Okay, and then we have the final one, blonde vanquisher with pink outfit. So we change the look of the main character here. So there were no picture. Description, besides this smaller one. My custom vanquisher that I created by editing other mod files in Photoshop. I ended up with this in 2 or 3 hours. I edited other mods files and merged others. The Vanquisher has blonde hair, pink bikini, starter armor, pink garter belt, and a custom face with makeup. There is a alternative body. Alternative body with a white garter belt in files if anybody wants to use that. Okay. So that's the mods I am using. Now let's start the game. That's a problem. It says it can't find the file. That wasn't ever a problem with the. I believe when I had the CD version of the game. We'll try to start it then. I need to find the actual game. Maybe we'll need to start it through Steam. Torchlight. Hello, Mr. Nyren here. So I had a problem starting the game for a while. So this is my current Vanquisher. She starts on Act 3. So I believe I had played... I ended the second episode at the same location where I start now. But I believe I did manage to delete like a few minutes of the game that I had recorded previously, but nothing of importance was lost. I believe the only thing that I lost was the intro text of the third act. So I had, when you enter each act, there is a intro text and a narrator speaking. Excuse me. Okay, so the music is quite high, but when entering each act, there is a story. A narrator will tell you about the new act, and it's a text which moves downwards, and then there is a narrator speaking. And I managed to delete that recording of that text, which means that we do not have the text anymore. I will need to replay the entire first and second act if I want to have that starting text. I might be able to cheat by using it from a different video. If I can find the YouTube video with that text, then I might be able to cut that part from the video and add to this video. But I managed to delete the final few minutes of the second episode. So this starts after the text, which means the story isn't present if I would start the game now. But my character looks like this currently. I'm a little surprised that she has grey hair. She's supposed to be blonde. If I click on new character, what will happen then? Yeah, mod seems to work because I've added a... I added new mods to the game, adding lots of new character classes as well, and new pets. So if we take a look at the character classes, we can take a look at the pets first. So the original pet is this wolf, or a cat, this cat, dog and cat. The dog looks kind of like a wolf, but it's a dog. Then the mods will enable other creatures as pets. So we have the aloe gel. We have the Arctic Tiger. We have the Bengal Tiger, Black Tiger, the Burrower, or Burrower. And we have the Cave Flyer. We have the Construct. We have the Corrupted Murs, or Merc. We have the Disciple. Yeah, the dragon spawn. Electric elemental. Ember colossus. And the ferret. I believe there are more. We have a fire elemental. Gel. We have the ghost. Goblin. Goblin hound. The horse. So we can have a horse as a pet too. And the ice elemental. The imaginary. We have the crag. We have the lich. The mech construct. And the mech crawler. We have the Ordrak and the Face Beast. And then we have the Poison Elemental, the Pygmy, the Ratman, Skeleton, Spider, the Troll, the Tuatara. And the dwarf, the Vercolin, the Vilebracken, the White Tiger, the Wisp, reminds me of the Wisps of Warcraft 3, Sealot, and the Zombie. Okay. Then we have the original classes. One I'm playing is the Vanquisher, this character. And I seem to have this look on my character, I don't know why, it should be blonde. Okay, then we have the Destroyer, and we have the Alchemist. Then we have the new character classes, most of them have the same base models, some of them have new. So we have the Airbender. Probably inspired by the last Airbender. Still using the model of the Alchemist. We have the Assassin. Might be inspired by Diablo 2. We have the Barbarian. Also inspired by Diablo 2. The Demon Lodgest. Demon Lodgest. This is an Alchemist, but with a different skin. Okay. Reminds me of a Necromancer. We have an Enchanter. Also using the Vanquisher model. The Executioner. Using the Alchemist model. The Foamer. She's also using the Alchemist. And we have the Fury. Using the Vanquisher. Then we have the Gunblade, reminds me of Final Fantasy 8, and he's using the Alchemist 2. We have the Guardian, another Alchemist. We have the Ice Queen, another Vanquisher. We have the Kensai, another one. Then we have the Nether Mage. So all of these have different specs, different attacks and abilities. They no longer have the vanilla abilities. These three have the vanilla. Then all of these have different attacks and skills. They are completely different compared to the original ones, even if they have the same model as the base. There are a few that should have different models too. So this is the Nether base. Nether Mage, I mean. And then we have the Shaman. We have the Spirit Dancer. Took a while to load with some of them. And we have the Sorceress. Actually, that one should be different. I actually managed to mod this myself, so it used an alchemist, but I followed a guide in order to download this model, I believe, but I had to edit some files to make this character, this model. So now the sorceress of this game looks a lot like the sorceress of Diablo 2. I always thought that this character, she's a character in the game, one of the NPC characters, non-playable characters. I always thought she looked like a Diablo 2 sorceress. So I managed to mod the game to use her as the model for the sorceress class. So the mod that added classes to the game allowed me to play as a sorceress with the skills of a sorceress, probably inspired by Diablo 2 sorceress, but she still looked like a Vanquisher. So I downloaded this model as a playable character, and then I modified the files to connect the model to the sorceress, and now we have the sorceress looking like this. The problem is that if we use a different model than the alchemist, the destroyer and the vanquisher, then they can't ever change their looks when they get new gear, so they will always look like this. If you use these three as the model, then they will get new armors and such when you pick them up, but with any custom model you will always have the custom model. You won't get a new helmet or a new glove or new boots or new armor. You will get new weapons, but everything else, I believe, will always look like this. If we play the sorceress, we will always look like this. But I still thought it was cool to have a sorceress that looks like Diablo 2 here. Okay, and then we have the... We already checked the spirit dancer. We have the Valkyrie. And the Stone Brother. And the Warlock. And the War Mage. He has some cool abilities, even if it looks kind of glitched in this view. Some cool auras. Okay, then there were two other models that uses that are using unique models that I want to check now. So we have the Paladin. Let's check her first. She looks like this. So she is the Vanquisher, but she has a unique blonde hair and white armor and unique weapons. Start a unique shield, unique sword, etc. And she's a paladin. I once played a paladin, a female human paladin in World of Warcraft, and she looked kinda like this. Okay, then we have the Lady Knight, which is a unique model, real cool one, with a unique face and unique hair and such. But I believe this one can actually change her body. She might be using the Vanquisher body or something, but she has a different head and face. So of course I would want to play as Paladin or Lady Knight. I believe I'm more interested in playing the Lady Knight. We can also read about them down here. So Lady Knight, Divine Warrior, is an expert in melee combat, has power of light to conquer her foes. Okay, and Paladin. Paladin uses the power of light to destroy evil wherever it is found. And the sorceress. Sorceress is a master of elements, using fire, ice, and lightning to decimate her foes. So all of these three are interesting to me, but we are playing the vanilla Vanquisher, so I will play her for now. Don't know why she has black hair, though. No idea. So we can load character. This is the only character. Hard difficulty, and reset level 12. And the name is Vale, just like the NPC Vanquisher. Let's join the game to see if she still has black hair. And she has the dog pet, because I wanted to use the vanilla one. Unfortunately she has grayish hair. I believe she had blonde hair when I played. Don't know why that is. Yeah, if I remove this hat, she still has black hair. She isn't supposed to have that. Very weird. So this is the start of Act 3. You can go up the stairs. And we are here, this location where we kill the boss and such. Stairs down. Then we would normally get the info about this place and such, but I deleted that stuff. I managed to delete one recording too much. I believe when I record there are many different video files, and I deleted one too many. Okay, so we are in the beginning of Act 3. I will try to fix her hair. I don't like that she has grey hair. Now she looks worse than the old vanilla one. I played with her using blonde hair in both acts, but now for some reason that mod is not active. Alright, let's exit to the title. Thanks for watching, and this is the video to show off the mods I'm using in the game Torchlight 1 for PC. And next time you will see this game, I will continue with the next act, and probably, hopefully, the hair of the character will be fixed. Hello again. So this is just a quick look at the character. So she looks like this with the hair fixed. Okay, I had to uninstall the submod and then, or the mod, and then I had to install it again. Then it worked. So I am afraid that maybe there are other mods that would need uninstalling and then reinstalling again. I don't know, because this is really annoying. I don't know how the sun can be this high. Okay, so now we can hear better. Okay, sound volume. Okay, let's continue the game, and we will enter. We are on Act 3, so the minions should be here for an unlimited duration. They need to be killed in order to disappear. We have the wolf pet. I didn't want any unique pet when playing. Originally I played the vanilla game as the Vanquisher, and I originally wanted to play this game as it was in vanilla. Then I found all the mods, but I still wanted to play it somewhat like in vanilla. Fortunately my save got corrupted, as I said, and I had to restart everything, and then I used this character instead because I liked her look better. So she didn't look like this from the beginning. We have gotten some gear. You click on the inventory, we can see that she looks like this, and we have some spells and a lot of fishes. So fishes in this game can transform me. So transform into a gel for 120 seconds. I am going to use some of these that are limited to certain time periods. For example, this one for 120 seconds is fine to use. I don't want to use any fish which will permanently change me to a creature, because I'm not playing to play as a monster. Transform into a troll permanently, I don't want that. Okay, but any fish that transforms me for a limited duration of time is fine. Okay, then we have some gear, so we can have different weapons. We have the pole gun of the savage here, so it's probably a gun of some sort. Yes, pretty good weapon, a rare weapon, I believe, a blue one, a rare rifle. Then we have the current weapon, the skillful skeleton bow of venom, a rare bow. I prefer it. We had better skills with the bow. Then we had the yak buckle, the yak boots. We have the yellow spiked gloves. So our weapons and our boots and our gloves are rare. Then we have some enchanted trinkets, and they are uncommon, I believe. Green is uncommon. And then we have these unique stuff. We have the unique chest armor, the Nargothrall's vest, and then we have unique helmet, homunculus helmet. We have the homunculus belt and the talon shoulders. So we have quite a few unique items. They are better than the rare ones. And we have some spells. We have the Fireball 1, Heal All 2, Frost 1, Identify Spell, Summon Flaming Sword 1, Summon Flaming Sword 1, there 2, and we have the Haste 1. Don't know, we are not using any of those. We are using the Summon Zombies 1, the Heal Self 1, and the Silence 1. Okay, and they are added here as well, so we can use them easily. We have some skills. We have the Frost Pylum and the Needle Arc. We also have the Heal Self there. Okay, we have equipment. We have some mana potions and big mana potions. We have some healing potions and the big health potion. And we have a ton of portal scrolls and identity scrolls. And we can have up to 200 of each item now. As stated in the mod description that you showed previously. Okay. I believe my character has better skills now than previously. So as a mark and as an arbiter, we have the lightning bomb. Then we have the flame trap and the dual wielding. So we can dual wield two weapons at once. Then we have the rogue abilities. Then we have the needle arc, the stab, the armor expertise, and the wind of justice. And then marksman. I have spent most of my skills. We will have the ricochet. We have the ranged weapons exercise, which will increase my skill in with ranged weapons. And then we have the frost pylum, the critical strikes. And we have the offensive spell mastery, increasing my offensive spells. We have the seeking shot, so probably like the Amazon attack, where it can find the enemy. It's like finding the enemy when you fire it. Okay, and then we have the adventurer, improves the potency of potions and such. Okay, so I believe we have better skills than we had in with the first character. It's the same skills, but I spent them better this time. I believe I did a better job playing this game the second time. Okay, 3. This is the attack. Don't want to go move too close to the enemy there, but they're undead there. Okay. They might be our undead, these guys. Then we have 4. Yeah, we have an attack that attacks many at once, and then an attack that is good against one enemy. Okay. And our pet is still the dog here. So the pet is named Spot now instead of Wolfie, because I forgot the name I had given the pet. Okay, so that was stupid, but yeah, it's still a wolf at least, or a dog. Okay, there is a mod which changes this into a real wolf too. So there is a mod that makes this dog a real wolf. Of course that would be more badass looking, but for now I don't really care. So the Vanquisher is looking like this at the moment, and this is where we will continue our playthrough of Torchlight 1 as the Vanquisher, now with mods increasing the look of the model. The game is increased in many ways, with different enhancements to pets and stashes and chests and items and prices and gameplay and such. And also, I believe locations are darker. I believe I used a mod that made locations darker and less colorful, but I might have deactivated that one. I didn't see it amongst the mods that I previewed. It's probably one of the unused mods. Because I wanted to play this game as it originally looked. So when we play as another character later, we will probably change the look of stuff to be more dark, like in Diablo 2. But in this game, I believe the locations are more like the vanilla game. But now with some enhancements, thanks to all those mods I previewed. Okay, so when I get back to this game, we will continue our journey as the Vanquisher and play the third act. But for now, I will need to go and eat, and it won't be a part of this video. And I plan on probably trying out the Alchemist and the Berserk. I mean the Alchemist and the Destroyer. I want to play those classes as well. And then when it comes to the new modded classes, I believe maybe I will play the Lady Knight and the Paladin, because they had cool looks. But at least the Lady Knight, I believe the Sorceress also could be of interest. But the Lady Knight with the unique look, I probably will try as well. Okay, thanks for watching. See ya. We are playing on hard difficulty, by the way. Okay, ciao.